In today's demonstration, I'm going to show you how to make an isoflare, also known as a bubble flare. The reason for making the flare would be the same as the double flare. You've replaced the line or you've cut one to length, and you need to reproduce the end so you can put the car back together. Maybe the breaker lines were rusty, maybe they got damaged in some way, and you're doing a repair. So we're going to show you how to do that today. It's just a couple easy steps. You shouldn't have any trouble at all. So let's get right to it.
Let's take a look at the bubble flaring kit. You're going to get this kit from the tool room with one tool chip. Inside of the kit are several pieces. The first one's going to be the flaring bar. The other pieces are going to be the adapters. And the one you need is already attached to the yoke. Then there's the yoke itself. And then the cutting tool to cut the brake line. All of that should be in there when you get it. Make sure it's all in there when you return it. To flare the line, just like the double flare, I'm going to get the tubing cutter out, put it on a little 3-inch piece of brake line, and I'm going to tighten the wheel just until it touches, the cutting blade touches the line. I'm going to rotate the cutter and then turn in the cutting blade. Rotate the cutter, one revolution, turn the cutting blade. I'm going to continue to do this nice and evenly until I'm able to cut off a little section of line. And that section of line should be approximately 3 inches long. After you've cut the line, it's going to pinch it in a little bit inside the line. So you want to take a little reamer and ream out the end of the line. I'm using my pocket screwdriver because I have it with me. But there is also a piece on one of the cutters to do that with, a little wedge-shaped piece. After reaming it out, I'm going to take the file. I'm going to flatten off the top a little bit, get the burrs off from it. I'm going to put a chamfer on the edge, which is what I'm doing right here with it laying on its side. Just make sure it's nice and smooth, nice and flat. After it looks appropriate on both ends, I'm going to get the flaring bar out, and I'm going to put it in the vise. Here, we're showing you the top of the tool with the line sizes on it and the concave setting on it. That's the side you're going to use. This side here with the flat with no writing is the bottom. So that's the top. We want the top to face up when it's in the vise. Once the flaring bar is in the vise, I just loosen up the wing nuts, put the line in, and close the wing nuts just so I can hold it in place. I'm going to reposition the line in just a minute. So this is just barely holding it. The brake line has to be flush with the flaring bar, and I'm going to again use my pocket screwdriver here just to make sure the top of the line is flush with the flaring bar. And once I get it to where it's flush, I'm going to use the yoke, the handle on the yoke, to turn in the wing nuts to tighten the tool. I need the flaring bar to be tight. I do not want the line to slip when I'm pressing it. Just tighten up both the wing nuts. Once the wing nuts are tight, I'm going to put the yoke on it. And you can see where the little dimple there goes in the line, and then the cutouts in the yoke have to be turned clockwise and secured to the flaring bar. So I'm going to set it over and turn it to lock it. You can see if I just go up and down with it there, it doesn't lock. I need to turn it clockwise to lock it in. I'm just going to turn down the threaded rod on the yoke until that little protrusion that's sticking out of the adapter goes into the top of my line. I'm now going to turn the handle on the yoke until my adapter sits right on top of the flaring bar. Once those two pieces touch, that's all the tighter I need to get it. You won't be able to compress it any further. Once I do that, you can see I'm going to back off the yoke, and the yoke is still kind of attached to the brake line there. It won't come loose. So I'm going to unscrew the yoke while it's attached to the flaring bar, and it'll pull it right off. Then once you do that, you're going to remove the brake line from the flaring bar. You can see I just was turning it the wrong direction there just for a second. So I want to make sure I'm paying attention to that. Loosen up the wing nuts and then inspect your line. The line, you can see, has a nice shiny end on it. That looks really nice. It's symmetrical when I look at it from the side. I look at it from the end. It's nice and round and symmetrical there. Also have the lines that have been pressed into the brake line itself. So those little grooves come from the flaring bar. If those are all intact and looking really sharp, then I know my line did not get pressed down and did not slip in the flaring bar. And that's it. You're done.